Hello dear students, I welcome you all for the lecture series of Object Oriented Programming. In this lecture, we are going to see macros. We are going to see the different types of macros and how to declare the macros. We will also see the preprocessor directives. At the end of this lecture, you will be able to introduce macros, you will be able to declare macros, as well as you will be able to understand the different types of macros. Preprocessor. The C++ compiler evaluates certain preprocessing directives before actually starting to compile a source code. These preprocessing directives are lines in our program that start with hash. These directives allow us to communicate with the preprocessor. For example, hash include statement in our program tells the compiler what kind of system calls and libraries you want to use in our program. For example, hash include iostream, hash include string, etc. C processor directives. There are number of steps involved while writing a program and executing a program in C as well as in C++. A programmer write a source code in a code editor and store that source file with program.cpp. After that, this file is processed by the preprocessor and an expanded source code file is generated. This expanded file is compiled by the compiler and an object code file is generated named as program.obj. Finally, the linker links this object code file to the object code of library functions to generate the executable file named as program.exe. If you observe, after writing the code and before compiling the code, the preprocessor works. That preprocessor takes some libraries which are required for our program execution and then generate an expanded source code, and then this expanded source code goes to the compiler and then we compile the program and the compiler will generate the machine code file, that is .obj file. Let us see what is macros. Macros are one of the preprocessor directives. It is a piece of code in our program which is given some name. Whenever this name is encountered by the compiler replaces the name with the actual piece of code. Before we use the macro, we shall define it with hash define directive followed by the macro name and then the code it should be abbreviated for. For example, hash define max 200. Here, hash define is our preprocessor, max is our macro, and 200 is the value, is the code assigned to the macro max. Some macros are constant and some of them can be defined to take the argument. Now here, max is our constant macro. Let us see the example. Hash define limit 5 is the macro definition. Here, hash define is our preprocessor, whereas limit is the name of macro and 5 is the definition, the value of that macro limit. So whenever that limit word, limit macro encountered by the compiler will replace that limit word with the 5 value. Now let us see the main function. In main function, we have for loop as integer I is equal to 0, I is less than limit I plus plus. Now here, limit will be replaced by 5. So we will get the output as I is equal to 0 to I is equal to 4. Cout statement will print that output. We will get the output as 0 to 4. Now if you observe that limit is replaced by 5 by the compiler and hence we got the output as 0 to 4. If we would have a limit as 9, the value of limit as 9, then we would have got the value or the output as 0 to 8. Now let us go with the macro with arguments. We can also pass the micro arguments to the macros. As I told you, macros defined with the arguments work similarly as the functions. As we know that whenever the compiler call that function, we have a function declaration and function definition in our program. So whenever the name of that function occur, the definition of that function will be called by the compiler and that code will be executed by the compiler in the same way macros with arguments work. Please observe the example. Here, hash define area L, B, L star B is the macro. Now, to the area macro, that is uppercase area is our macro, and two parameters are passed to that macro as L and M, B. And after that, the piece of code which is supposed to be executed whenever that macro is called, it is written as the area of rectangle as L multiplied by B. Now, let us observe the main function. Here, the length is given as 10 and base is given as 5, and the area, the result of that rectangle will be stored in the variable area. Now, here in the area variable, the two parameters are passed as length and base. As you know that the value of length is 10 and base is 5. Now, the area macro, area with capital letters, will be called and which has a piece of code as L multiplied by B. So, we will get the area as length multiplied by base, that is 10 multiplied by 5. So, final output, the result we will get as a 50. Okay, so you can write this program and compile this program on your system and you can check the output.